I got my first job playing video games.
As you know, for the past many decades, the current practice for the reception of the sacraments has been baptism as an infant, a first communion about the second grade, and confirmation sometime after that, depending on your parish, depending on your diocese, sometimes around the 7th or 8th grade, sometimes into high school years as well. The Diocese of Springfield and Illinois is in the process of switching that order so that we would receive baptism and then confirmation and then First Communion. And we call that the restored order because for the first 1800 or so odd years of the Church, that's how the sacraments were received. Baptism, confirmation, and then the Eucharist. If you look in the Catechism of the Catholic Church, it reminds us that it is the Eucharist that completes our initiation and not confirmation. So a good question to ask is, if it is the Eucharist that completes Christian initiation, how did it happen that we began confirming people after they had their first communion? And the answer goes back to France, around 1849, when the French bishops, for reasons of a greater period of catechesis, decided that they would delay the reception of confirmation until after First Communion. At that time, it was customary then to receive First Communion around the age of 16, but to receive confirmation around the age of 12 or 14. It would depend on when the local bishop could make his rounds in his diocese to get from place to place. When the Pope found out about that delay with the breaking of the sacramental order, he asked them why they did it, and they said for a greater period of catechesis. He told them to put it back, and it never happened. And that practice of separating the sacramental order, distorting it, if you will, spread throughout the Church, even to the United States, and we've maintained it as we have it up until now. The reason we're hoping to do this is not only to put us in greater unity with the early Christians, but also as a way to try to see what the Holy Spirit can do in the hearts of His people. We know so often that people who are receiving confirmation when they're in seventh grade or later have very often already formed their consciences, either properly or not. And in many cases, we have people receiving confirmation who will tell us, if they answer honestly or we ask honestly, that they don't really believe what's happening, and that they really close themselves off to the grace of the Holy Spirit. They don't want to call upon His gifts in their everyday life. But we find that younger people, particularly around the age of second grade or third grade, are very open to the faith. And so what we're hoping to do is to infuse them with the gifts of the Holy Spirit from a young age so that as they grow and mature with the pressures of the outside world around them, they can call upon the gifts of the Holy Spirit, His wisdom, His counsel, His courage, to help them grow and mature as Christian disciples. So that through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit at a younger age, with the graces of the Spirit, the fruits of the Spirit taking effect for more years, more of their formative years, that we can see what transformation in society God wants to give us all through the outpouring of confirmation. The restoration of the sacramental order is one means towards that. Of course, it doesn't mean that once someone is confirmed and receive their first communion, typically now from the bishop, that their formation as Christians is done. Of course, that's never been the case, even though people often treat it like that. The intention, the hope, the desire, the dream now is that once people have been fully initiated with confirmation and First Communion around the age of third grade, that they would then deepen their understanding of what it means to be a Christian disciple. As one example, one way to do that, if we think of the sacrament of penance, of reconciliation, of confession, is from year to year to delve deeper into that. As we grow, as we mature, as situations of life change, the ways that we can sin become more numerous, they deepen, they become more severe, they alter. A second grader doesn't sin in the same way that a 45-year-old does. So we can continue to unfold that. What does it mean to confess our sins to the Lord? What do sins mean? What are they? But then also, what does it mean to receive His mercy again and again and again? All of this, by delving into the mysteries of the faith, can give us a deeper appreciation for them and can help us grow in the love of God. We hope we've answered your question today, and if you have any other questions or any comments to make, please do so down below. Thank you. God bless.